Hey everybody, and welcome back to another episode of 7-Minute AE Tutorials, where you learn tips, tricks, and shortcuts in less than 7 minutes. No BS, just AE. Okay, so this week's tutorial is going to be somewhat of an extension of last week's. We'll be using shape layers to create custom transitions and saving them as presets. So let's get right to it. Right click, new shape layer, add a group, change this to color 1, and then within that color, let's add a rectangle and a fill. Let's change the color of this fill. Let's open up rectangle path, and you see here your size options. If you unclick this link, you can manipulate the width and height of these independently. See if they're together, it makes a square. If we uncheck this, you can adjust the width and the height. Let's make the width 1000 and the height 2500. So let's move forward to 2 seconds. We'll be using the position properties within the group, not the main transform position for the entire shape layer. We'll be using the color group position. Let's add a keyframe. We want this to come all the way to the left. And now if you right click on keyframes, you know, you can use keyframe assistant to add easy ease, easy in, easy out. The first shortcut I want to show you today is if you click on the keyframe, hit shift F9, and you have an easy in keyframe. This may not seem like a big deal, but for those of you who use a lot of keyframes, you understand how valuable knowing these shortcuts for keyframes are. So now if you click on shape layer just anywhere in here and you click the I button, it brings you back to the very beginning of the track here. And we want this obviously to be over all the way over to the right. After Effects will generate a Bezier keyframe anytime you've already created an easy in or easy out. This is the graph editor. And basically what this does is it gives you even more control over these keyframes. So if you grab this handle here and pull it all the way to the left as far as you can go, so we can even pull this over more like that. So it's going to be really fast and then slow. So it just kind of comes in and then slowly stops. Now what we're going to do is use Control D to duplicate the color. Change the color to something else. It doesn't matter what it is. If we highlight the shape layer and hit U, it'll bring up our keyframes here. Now, here's another shortcut. If you highlight just position here, notice all of your keyframes will be selected. So you can move either one of these and it will move all of them. So let's page down 1, 2, 3 times and pull this over to here. Page down moves forward a frame at a time. Page up moves backwards a frame at a time. So page up, page down. Okay, and for this transition, we're going to add one more group. Click on color 2, Control D to duplicate it. Again, click U to see our keyframes, and we want to start here and page down 3 times, 1, 2, 3. Click on position, grab this first keyframe and move it over. Let's change this color, so like that. There we go. As I mentioned last week, to save this as a preset, we need to highlight everything within the contents, and if you have mask or you have transform properties for the entire shape layer, you can also select that. We are going to just select color 1, 2, and 3. Let's go up to animation, save animation preset. These presets save to your documents, Adobe, whatever version you're using. I'm using 2015, and user presets. Now, generally, these will come to this general user presets area. I've created folders. The thing that's cool about this is that this is reflected in your After Effects project. So you have effects, shape layers, transitions, trap code. Well, over here, I've got effects, shape layers, transitions, and trap code. So whatever you create in this folder here, it will be reflected in your After Effects project. So let's go into transitions and let's name this rectangle transition 1. Okay, so now to test this out, let's get rid of this shape layer. Now let's right click, new shape layer. Come into our animation presets here. Under user presets, we saved it to transitions. And there it is, rectangle transition. Now remember to have your marker wherever you want the keyframes to be dropped. So let's pull in the rectangle transition. Hit U to see our keyframes. There you go. Now, this is a very, very simple transition. The reason why I wanted to do this is because I want to show you how you can use this one transition and suddenly have multiple versions of it. Click on R for your rotation. It defaults to 0. Now, watch this. Let's change it to 90. Now, it goes from bottom to top. Change it to 180. And it goes from right to left. Change it to 270. And it goes from top to bottom. Now, the reason why I made these shape layers 1000 by 2500 is because if you say you want it to go diagonally, let's make the rotation 35. Now, the only thing you may have to kind of adjust this a little bit to get it to go off screen. So say we'll do 1725. It's easy to remember. 1725. We'll change all these beginning to 1725. And we want our out position. Let's try negative 1625. So now it begins completely off screen and ends completely off screen. Now say that you have done what I just did, like where you created the shape layer, you've already saved the transition as a preset and you really like it, but then you did some adjustments the way I just did. So now you're like, well, what do I do about that? Because you don't have a transition that you can't just pop in and use. So I'll show you how to fix that. Open up your contents again, select color 1, 2, and 3, go to animation, save animation preset, and it will default back to the last place that you saved. The last place we saved was user presets, transitions. If you just select that again and hit save, do you want to replace it? Yes, you want to overwrite that. So now watch this. Right click, new shape layer, animation presets, user presets. Let's go back to our transitions and bring in the rectangle. Now again, make sure your marker's at the beginning. And there it is. Now let's double check to get those position keyframes. And again, see 1725 and negative 1625. So this is a very, very simple kind of transition, but it's something that may be of use to you. Again, you just need to adjust your rotation to have this transition animate in and out in various places. I will save this project file in the comments below, and I hope this helped you out. This is a new channel, and I'd love to do a lot more of these, so please subscribe, like, share, and comment. Let me know in the comments below if there's anything in particular you'd like to see. So I will see you next week. Thanks for watching. Thank you.